Hi everyone, in this video I'll walk you through the new SharePoint Start experience. This increases the way how you create pages in SharePoint. Every page that you create there is stored in your OneDrive, and then you can decide to collaborate on it with your colleagues and finally publish the page in a specific SharePoint site. Alright, enough talk, let me walk you through this new experience. Let's go! Here I am in the SharePoint home site in one of my tenants. How I can open the new SharePoint Start experience? There are two easy ways. The first one, if you are navigating a SharePoint site, you will have the SharePoint label here on top in the navigation bar. Otherwise, you can open the waffle menu and you will land exactly on the same new experience by clicking on the SharePoint icon. Let's do that in this way right now. So here we have currently a mixed experience. We have the new preview experience, and in order to open this, you have to click on this button. This is mixed and hybrid, let's say, because you have both experience, classic one, the old one, and then the new one. So in the old one, we were used to have a summary of all sites followed, the recent sites, saved for later, the news, and all SharePoint sites where I have membership there. So where I have where I am a owner or a member. Now let's start the new experience by clicking on the button Go to Pages. Finally, I have now the new experience up and running. A short tutorials opens. You can draft pages easily now with this new experience. Let me click on next. I can even create a page just to try the new experience. Let's close now this mini tutorial and let's have a look this new landing page. This would be the new start experience in SharePoint. So at the very on top we have a bunch of templates that we can use to draft and to create pages. So we have status update, announcement, basic newsletter, then we have topic, process, and blank. These are currently the templates that we can use in this new start experience. Down below you have recent pages, and this is crucial and very important because here you can group for all or the pages that you are just drafting without publishing. And moreover, you have a bunch of columns where you can monitor the status, how many views they have, modified, and the activity. So the status column is very important, especially when you start drafting pages. You can switch across drafts and publish it, so it's more easy to follow up and add content on pages that you are drafting. Alright, let's start to create some page now. Let's click now here on this template, announcement, and let's start to draft a page. When you use this new start experience, the page is dropped in your OneDrive. As you can see here, I am in my personal OneDrive. A new library will be created there called SitePages. I'll show you now where you can find this in your OneDrive. But before to do it, let's save this content. Let me just modify the title, announcement XXX. The text is already there because I reused an existing template. And here you have the classic experience of SharePoint, so you can have a preview how this news will look like in a mail. And here you can add wrappers, the classic SharePoint experience. You have design ideas if you want. You can change the look and feel of this page. But now let's say that I want to save this page as draft. I don't want to publish yet because I'm not ready. I'm going to save it. And what I can do now is share this page. I can send as an email if I want. Let's do that. And then I can type, for example, a bunch of colleagues that will work on this page together with me. and so they can have a preview of this one, but I can also send the link if I want to this page. So all I need to do is just come here in the share link, and then I can click on share page. So I will provide access to my colleague to edit the page with me. I can edit, and then let's click on send. There you go. Now let's see from another user perspective how this thing looks like. There we go. Adele Evans has received the email, and she can now open this page and she can start to work and collaborate on this page with me. By opening the link, she will immediately get access to the page that I just drafted, and this sit on my OneDrive, as you can see. So Adele can now edit the page, add content, and then she can even decide if publish this page or not. All right, let's go back to the Giuliano view and let's see where this page is landed. Here I am back as Giuliano. Let me open OneDrive now and let's see where this page is. So every page that you create with the new experience, start experience of SharePoint will be added in a special library, which is not visible here in your OneDrive. But if you open this page, you can see the URL. So let me do something now. Let me copy this URL and let me now paste this URL. So let's try to open this URL, site pages. And as you can see, I have now this SharePoint view, even if I have opened my OneDrive. So these are all pages that I created, the list of all pages that I created using the new SharePoint start experience. So here I have all options that you can have on SharePoint. So you can create automation with Power Automate, Power Apps, you can schedule the page to go live on a specific date, and then you can add alerts. So all SharePoint capabilities for document library are here. But this is the list of pages created using the new SharePoint start experience. So now let's say that I am ready to publish this page. So what I can do is publish this page, and this will still be available across my OneDrive. Just to show you more, let me open the share experience here. See that Nestor and Adele have access to this page. They can edit the page because I shared the link. So here I can also remove direct access to Adele, and the same for Nestor, because now I'm ready to publish the page, for example, or the collaboration is ended here. Let's say now that I'm ready to publish this page. So what I can do is click on publish page, and now this page is published. I can send us an email, copy the link to page, or I can share the page by sending the link. So this is available now, but it stay on my OneDrive space. It's still here, this page. Now let's go back to the experience that we have seen before by clicking, in this case, on this link, SharePoint. I will land here, go to the new page experience, and now I can see the announcement XXX just created and published. The status is published, and I have already 3 views, and this is a recap of all pages that I reused, that I published. So this page now is there. So it seems that I'm no longer able to republish this page in a SharePoint site, for example. So this is something that you have to keep in mind. So if you click on republish, this page, it's still stay on my OneDrive. So what you need to do if you want to propagate this page in a specific SharePoint site collection, for example, could be by using a Power Automate. So by opening the OneDrive space using this view, going on this URL with site pages, you can then create an automation that can push your page across SharePoint sites if you want. This is just one idea and workaround that you can use by not having the republish function here available. But now let's say that we want to start to create a new page. Let's go on process just to have content already there, just to not reinvent the wheel, but to reuse existing content. Okay, it's good to go already. So I can now, again, this is saved on my OneDrive space. And what I would like to do right now is publish this page directly in a specific SharePoint site collection where I have access. So I can, for example, target the global HR, and then I can click on publish. And then finally, this page will be saved in this site collection, which is the global HR. So the URL changed because now I am in sites, global HR, site pages. There you go, I am here. So, but let's see what happens in OneDrive. So let me now go back on this tab and let me reopen the link that we have seen before, that should be here. And let me now target my OneDrive and the library site pages. So the page is no longer available here. So I can no longer see the second page that I created because this now has been moved to the global HR site. Another thing to consider is that going back is that now I can monitor all pages. This is very comfortable in this recent pages summary. So here I can see now that the second page that I created is no longer dropped in my OneDrive like the first one, but now is dropped in the global HR SharePoint site. Okay, we have seen the new SharePoint Start experience. What do you think about it? It's good? Bad? Do you like it? Add a comment down below, let me know your thoughts. I hope to see you next time. Bye.